Sure. First off, thank you for being here. It's good to be with you guys. Excited that we're here still playing at this time of the season. It's been a wonderful season. We have an incredible group of young women that have put their head down and gotten after it since the beginning of preseason. To be at this stage, you know, making it to the ACC championship game, an incredible game. We've been very consistent with our performance from since day one. Some remarkable analytics from our season have been, you know, we went through the entire ACC season, and I think we conceded only 8 goals and 10 in the entire non-conference and conference part of the season, which is very hard to do. You know, I always say as a coach, if you can get through your conference play and have single digits against goals against, you're going to give yourself a championship opportunity. We've also been good on the other end. You know, here we are, and we've scored over 50 goals this year. It's been a great combination, a good balance of attack and defending. Obviously, our goalkeeper, Hallie Mackwich, has been, you know, spectacular. You know, I think she's been one of the best, if not the best, goalkeeper in the country, leading the nation in shutouts, giving us the big saves when we need them. It's a good vibe on the team. It's a great chemistry between experience and young players. You know, we had 9 players recognized for all ACC recognition. You know, 3 of our freshmen, Danny Davis, Tatum Short, and Jenna Tobia, you know, made the all-freshman team and have been great contributors to our season. Yeah, this is, you know, I was to share with you what's the secret sauce for this group. To be honest with you, this group loves each other. It's an incredible group of people, and they care for each other. They not only get along on the field, they get along off the field. And to be honest with you, it's been fun. It's just been fun to sit back and watch them play. You know, we had a little coming to Jesus talk back in the spring. We weren't really particularly happy with our previous season. You know, we did okay, but we underachieved. And they made the conscious decision that they were going to do something about it. And that's what you do in sports. You know, you have times to respond. And sometimes the best times to respond is when you come off a bad moment or you lose, or you find out what somebody's made out of. And this team has done something. You know, one of our big words that we use during the season is consistency. And this has probably been the most consistent team that I've had since I've been at Clemson. And that's including the 2016 team that won the ACC championship. This group has really been, they've shown up mentally, physically, every game. And that's been really impressive, and it's been fun to watch. And, you know, they put themselves in a position. Look, we're in the second round of the NCAA, and there's only 32 teams left. And, you know, we're trying to rewrite a little bit of Clemson history here. You know, can we be the first women's team to make it to the College Cup? No one's going to give it to you. You got to go out and earn it. We've been all about that, you know, but our focus has been one game at a time. You know, our complete concentration is on Columbia on Friday, and it's a quick turnaround, so we'll be ready for that. But we're not thinking about anything else besides playing Columbia from the Ivy League on Friday here at Historic Riggs. I'll take any questions that you may have.
What's it going to take? I'm Beth from Fox, Carolina. What's it going to take to make that goal happen between now and the cup to get your team there, and how much of it and do they have? And, you know, we know so much at this point is winning is believing that you can win, that you expect to be there, that you have the right to be there. How much do your ladies have that, and what else is it going to take to make that happen?
Well, you're right about the belief, but more importantly, you have to earn it. Right? No one's going to gift you anything. Like, look, we play in the most difficult league in the country in the ACC, and out of any sport, it's not even close. And if you're playing one of the teams that happen to be near the bottom, if you just show up, you'll get beat, you'll get knocked out. So it's a big part of what we talk about is being consistent. And you also want to respect your opponent. How do you respect your opponent? You show up every day and you give them your best. And no one's going to gift anything to you. And so you might find yourself in a game where maybe, you know, our passing is a little bit off. You can win in other ways, right? Are you still grinding it? Are you still working? Are you committed? Are you fighting? We have those qualities and characteristics. That's, as a coach, I'm pleased to see that. And from my playing days, I can recall all these things. I'm not that old yet. But having that right chemistry and those belief and the intangible boxes getting checked, those are the things that are going to lead to me, all those things that I'm talking about, they're a byproduct of winning. And if we can continue to be consistent with the things that we've been, and the good news with our team is, like, we don't have to change anything. We've been doing all these things since day one. They've been hearing the same message from me. I'm not altering it. It's like, let's just be us. Let's be consistent. And that's in everything from our preparation to training to rest to recovery to game day to warm up to play. And like I've said, this has been the most consistent team that I've coached since I've been at Clemson. So again, and it's been fun. And not the easy thing, but the good challenge is all we have to do is show up and check that box. And if we do, we'll give ourselves a really good chance to win. No one's going to – hey, we've all watched sports that, this is clearly the best team. They're going to win. And they don't do it. And soccer is a cruel sport. It's one of those rare ones where you can go out and outshoot somebody 99-0 and still lose. So I'm cognizant of that. We're trying to keep the hunger and the fun and the desire with our kids. There are times I'm just trying to get out of the way because I think they've got a lot of it figured out. We're just trying to point them in the right direction and go and be successful. And to their credit, they've done the job. And that's going to be our message for Friday. Let's go out. Let's be us. Let's be the best version of Clemson we can be. And the result will take care of itself.
Coach John Merton, WSPA, talk about what this Columbia team, who do they resemble in the ACC, or is it a different style of play that you see from them?
It's a slightly different, very disciplined, very organized group, very good with the ball. They like to pass the ball. They remind me organizationally a little bit of Louisville and trying to play a bit like Duke. But to give them a compliment, they're just being Columbia. They're well coached. They're organized. Listen, any team that is in the round of 32 is a good team. So you have to, everybody has to respect one another. It doesn't matter what that number says next to your name. Oh, Clemson 1. It could be Clemson 16. It could be 18. It could be 20. It doesn't matter. You step on the field, you got to compete. So we know, listen, and congratulations to them. They won their first ever NCAA tournament game in the history of their program. That's awesome. So they're going to be excited to come down here and play at Clemson. Well, we're also going to be excited to play at Clemson, right? Here we have a chance to advance into the Sweet 16 and to continue to go to make, we don't want our season to end. This just happens to be the next opponent. And we're going to respect them, we're going to honor them, and we're going to go out there and show them all that by giving them our best.
Coach, you mentioned that meeting in the spring and the conscious decision that your team made. What kind of leadership have you seen emerge, and how much has your senior class played a role in that?
Great question. Probably one of the biggest reasons for our success. This year's, our leadership has been player-driven, and it's been awesome to see. We have a great group of leaders. Our two captains have been phenomenal. Like I said, I wasn't just saying it. It's just a laissez-faire comment to say that, they love each other. They really do care. I mean, they check in with each other. That chemistry part, I know from my own experience as an athlete, it's like, if you get a team and they're coming together, especially a female team, they can move heaven and earth. And I'm a Star Wars fan, so I always like to use the Force. Like, you can use the Force in your advantage, you're gonna have a pretty good success return on that. But that chemistry part is so critical. But you're right. We talked. This started back in the spring when we had, I always call it, we had a little bit of a New Jersey conversation. And we cleared the air on some things. And it was basically just like, all right, what are we going to do going forward? Are you going to do it? Are you going to talk about it? Or are we going to put actions into it? And to their credit, they've applied it that way. And to their credit, they're seeing they're reaping the rewards of it. And we're not done. Like, we wanted to win that ACC championship. It didn't happen to us. Our kids played great. It was a great game. We played a phenomenal team. And okay, so can we give ourselves another opportunity? The next opportunity is what? It's the College Cup. Can we earn the right to get there? If you get to the College Cup, I'm not a math genius, but at least gives you a 25% chance to win the national championship. It's kind of like I said with the ACC championship. If you make it to the final, you give yourself a chance. You're not in the final, you don't get to dance. So our objective is one game at a time. How do we get ourselves? How do we earn the right to get to the College Cup? And you also have to recognize there's other teams that are trying to do the same thing. It's not just us, right? So you do got to go out there and fight and battle and compete. And that's where some of the intangibles of athletics pops up. And, you know, I like what our crew has been doing. I love the leadership that has led the team. And I think they're going to continue to lead us well as we head towards the journey of the College Cup.
Environment that you guys have at Riggs, and maybe not necessarily an advantage, but the comfort of being able to play at home in front of your fans.
Well, don't be afraid to say it. We should have an advantage. We're at home. I mean, we earned the number one seed for some reason, right, was to get it. And I want to thank all those people that came out, all the Clemson fans and family that showed up at our last NCAA tournament game. The energy and the noise was exhilarating, and the players love it. You know, I tell Central Spirit all the time, like, you guys being here, you just don't know how much you help the team. When you're an athlete and you hear that yell, you that little bit of excitement, that cheer, it does carry you on, you know. So we want to make sure we could take advantage of that. And if we're fortunate enough to advance on Friday and be home on Sunday, we will need the same thing. And one thing I've known from, you know, this is my 13th season at Clemson, and I've had the pleasure of watching, you know, Mike Noonan's group, you know, go win the national championship and go deep into the NCAAs, and the crowds that have turned out that have been electrifying, and they can lift the game. I mean, it's one of the things I use in my recruiting spiel. When we have recruits, is like, you come and play at Clemson, like, it's unique. You come and win at Clemson, it's unique. They'll love you. They'll honor you, right? I love that stuff. I mean, what we saw the other night, I keep telling our team, like, we keep winning. Guess what? More people are going to show up. More people are going to pack it in, right? And we want to create that atmosphere. I've got this vision, and I hope we get there, that we're playing in the Elite Eight, and we have an opportunity to go to the College Cup. Because I think our crowd could help take us over across that line. I'm certainly glad we're here as opposed to being away. And again, I want to thank all those that came out, and hopefully we continue to get that type of support as we move forward.
Any other questions? Thanks, Coach.
Thanks for being here.